Okay, so let's begin the session. So, good morning, all. My name is Shrinkla. I'll be your trainer for this session of this training of Project Plus. So, I have been working into this organization from last 3-4 years. I provide training on different courses of project management, like Project Plus, Project Management Professional Course, PMP, CAPM, ACP. I provide training on ISO courses, on business analysis courses, on agile courses, on Scrum courses, and so on, ITIL, etc. And previous to this organization also, I was working into some other organizations as a trainer itself. So I have quite a good experience into this particular domain of training in different courses, different fields. And I talk a lot, obviously. And I'll be talking a lot. I interact a lot. So I will be asking questions to you guys also. And like doing normal chit chat also. Because otherwise we have to meet 5 days, complete 8 hours. So it's good if we are interacting so things go light. Otherwise sometimes it becomes dull and boring. So yeah, that's all. Okay. And anytime when you feel that my handwriting is something you are not able to read, please let me know. So the course that we are going to do is Project Plus. Name as in my name. Shrinkla Kare. Duration of this particular course is for 5 days. We'll be meeting 8 hours each day. Again, it is a complete theoretical course. Bit of questions and all will be there, small ones, but majorly it is going to be theory. Okay, so any one of you have any information about this particular course, like what exactly is Project Plus? Why do we do this? Okay. So this particular course, Project Plus, it is a very suitable course, we can say, for IT professionals who are managing small or complex or mid-level of projects. So this is, I would say, first of all, this is a first step towards the project. So over here into this particular course, it's not tough, I would say. It is easy to understand, but it is a bit lengthy. But because you guys have already worked upon, so the things that we are going to talk about, you will feel that, yeah, I have already done this. Or I have seen at least my manager or someone else doing the same. So work is like similar to whatever you are doing. But over here, they will be introducing new concepts to you. The terms that you guys might be using in your organization will not be same here. So this particular course will make you skilled, make you have gained a lot of knowledge on few things like how to manage the project lifecycle, about communication, about managing resources, about managing your stakeholders, making the documentation of the projects and all. So now, about this particular course, so I believe you guys are planning to give the exam also. So first of all, about the course content. So over here, we have total 14 chapters to cover. Course content. This lesson 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So there are total 14 chapters, 14 lessons that basically we need to cover into this particular training. So what I have planned, this is something I have planned, but again, it is subject to changes. Into day one, we are going to cover these 3 lessons. On our day two, we are going to cover these 3 lessons. four, five, six, then 7, 8, 9, something for day 3, 10, 11, 12, day 4, 13 and 14, day 5. This is something that I have planned, but again, it depends on something here. The whiteboard isn't visible to me. Have you started? Priyanka, can you see my board?
Shrikla, now I can. Thank you.
Okay, no problem. Okay. So this is the course content. And one more thing, on this whiteboard, I cannot write straight. So it's always like this, going down. So it's never straight. So yeah, and whatever notes I'm making, I'll make sure that I'll share these notes with you guys. So this is something what I have planned. Now, a quick bit of information about the exam. So this is, again, this is not a very tough exam. This is quite on the easier side. In this exam, you will be having 90 questions. In 90 questions, it will be like multiple choice of questions there will be, or bit scenario based they can make. What 90 questions you will be having, the time duration for the exam will be 90 minutes. So like 1 minute for each question. Now, in order to pass the exam, you need to score around 75%. Then you will be passing this particular exam. And to give the exam, you can give it on by going on to some testing centers, or you can give it online also. It completely depends on you. They have both the things with them. Till now, guys, any doubt, any query, anyone? Yes, no, maybe?
No, no questions.
Okay. Now, let us talk about literally the term, first of all, that is used over here, the name of this particular course. Project. Any understanding about what exactly is project? What is project? What do we mean by project?
I believe it's when a certain task needed to complete, to reach a certain goal or certain results, generally speaking.
Yes, true. Very good. Anyone else who would like to add on something here? Okay. So project is basically defined as a temporary endeavor. Undertaken to create a unique result, or you can say product or service. Hi, Sammy.
Hi, Assalamu Alaikum.
Alaikum Assalam. How are you?
Good, good. How about you?
I'm good too. Thank you. Okay, Sammy. So we have just started the course. We have been talking about what exactly the course is. Like my name is Shrinkla, but you can call me Shrey. The duration, the content. So we have been speaking about, like, there are 14 lessons that we need to cover into this 5 days of training. So I was giving the bifurcation that I have into my mind. But again, it depends on the state that you are going or whenever you are comfortable with. So 1, 2, 3 today, that's the day one. So we'll be doing 3 chapters today. Tomorrow, again, 3. Day 3, 3. Day 4, 2 chapters. And on the last day, we'll be doing 2 chapters. Fourth day, we'll be doing 3 chapters. And on the last day, we'll be doing 2 chapters. Now, we are discussing about literally what is project. Because everything that we are talking about is project. But what is project? So project is defined as a temporary endeavor undertaken to create a unique result, product, or service. Temporary endeavor. What does this particular term means? Temporary endeavor means that every project have a definite start date and a definite end date. Whatever projects you are doing, the duration can be for, you can say it can be for, project can be of 6 months, project can be for 1 year, it can be for 5 years, it can be for 10 years, but it's never gonna be like project is forever ongoing. No project is forever ongoing. Always and always, project have a definite start date and a definite end date. And all the time, project is creating something unique. Now, you can also say, like, if I take an example of WhatsApp. So similar to WhatsApp right now, there are so many platforms existing into the market, by which you can do calling, by which you can do video calling, status, put on your pictures and all. But there are a few features different. Suppose there's an application called as Viber. Viber is a very old application, but it is, you can say, very similar to WhatsApp. It's everything that's available on WhatsApp that is over there into Viber. So if you say, you can also say the functionality kind of wise, both of them are similar. But still, they are different. They are different projects. Why? WhatsApp have a different user interface. Viber have a different user interface. WhatsApp have a different logo. Viber have a different logo. Even if suppose that are also same. But still, the audience who are using it will be different. You cannot guarantee that all the people who are using WhatsApp are going to use Viber for sure. Or all the people who are going to use, who are using Viber, will be using WhatsApp also. So something is unique. And all the time in project, we create something unique, some unique results, you can say. So we are creating some product or we are creating some services. Clear, guys? What is project?
Yes, Shrinkla.
Yes.
Okay. Now, the second term that comes that is very popular, that is operations. In every organization, there is a department of operations. Any understanding about what is operations? What's the difference between a project team and an operations team?
I think the operation is implement for the project.
Implementation of the project, okay. Anyone else? Okay. So operations are basically ongoing activities. Or you can say repetitive activities. REPETITIVE. In operations, you are not doing something unique. You are not creating something unique. You are doing the same thing again and again, 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 and again. So for an example, if I take an example of, suppose, Toyota. Toyota is an organization who manufactures car. Or let's take an example of Hyundai. So when the one car is like designed, that is something that is done by the project team. Now, once the car is designed, then what exactly Hyundai is doing? Hyundai is simply selling the copy of that particular car. So this copy-pasting kind of thing, copying the car and selling it, will now come into the section of operations. till the time when we were building that car, designing that car, working on that particular car, it was coming under the category of project. Now, once the organization started selling it, they are literally making a copy of the same car. So that will come into the category of operations. Okay, now I want to ask a question to you guys. Okay, suppose I am coming to Riyadh. I saw your office building. I really liked your office building. I asked you to make the same building, exactly the same building for me in India. So how, what will you treat this particular thing as? Is it a project or is it operations?
Operations.
Okay, others?
It's kind of tricky, kind of both. Yeah. it's operation because you're not designing a new building, but I believe it's also a project because you have to take in mind the construction and the material. It's like designing the building again.
Anyone who would like to vote for operations or project? Okay. So guys, this is project. This is not an operations. Now, why is it project, not an operations? Even if you are making the exact same building in India for me, but still things are going to be different. The rules of Riyadh are different. The rules and regulations regarding to construction in India are different. People, workers, laborers whom you were working with in Riyadh were different. Obviously, you are not going to bring all the laborers from Riyadh here to India so that you can construct the same building. The people whom you are interacting with who will be working for you will be different. The material that you will be using will be also different. There will be some variations into the material also. If suppose everything was exactly the same, literally the same, if I ask you to make the same building next to, in suppose after 1 kilometer or in your Riyadh itself, then everything is same. In that scenario, this particular question, in that scenario, this will be operations. But right now, it will be categorized under project. Clear, guys? Why exactly this project?
Yes.
Yes, clear.
Okay. Okay, then. The next term that we have is your project management. Right now, I am telling you the basic terms that are used into the project. Obviously, these are some things that you will find on the PPT also, but kind of a background kind of thing that I'm trying to build over here, so that once you are going under the PPTs, you'll be like, hey, I know this particular thing. Okay, so why exactly we are here? We are here to talk about the project management. We are here to talk about project, whatever is going on in your organization, whatever type of projects are going on in your organization. Organization, small or big or simple or complex. So project management, you can say like project management can work on an undertaking of any size or any complexity. So sometimes there might be a scenario that you are working upon a project that lasts for complete for the last many years, whereas you are working, sometimes it can be like you are working on a project just for one day. So project management is like nothing new. Project management is a very old profession. So project management is existing for many years back. Even if the very small, whenever you are, we are really not aware of what exactly we are doing. But actually in our daily life also, we are managing simple projects. Like suppose in your family, someone have birthday. You are arranging a birthday party. That birthday party is also a project management. You are arranging a function kind of thing. That is also a project management. That is also a project. So the simple things, small things that we are doing into our daily life, that can be also few of them can be considered as a project. So project management, what does project management do? Project management turns an idea into a tangible goal. Then it systematically implements it. So what does we do into project management? We bring the right people together. We plan the work. Whatever obstacles are into their way, we clear the obstacles so that they can focus upon their work. We try to control the cost. We try to produce high quality of outcome. The real strength of any project management is like completing your projects efficiently at a very reasonable price and receiving the expected outcomes. Yeah, guys, project management, what is like bit of basic of project management? What is project management? What's happening over here? Yes, no.
Yes, yeah, Shrinkla, it's clear.
Okay. Now, there's one more term that is used in many organizations that is called as program. Any one of you have ever heard about program in like organization, or you have a program department or program manager in your organization? Okay. So program is basically, program is a group of similar projects. That are managed together for better coordination. So, suppose, let me paste the picture over here. Wait, give me a second. An example for the program. Okay, so in this particular example, so first of all, what is program? Program is like you are managing similar type of projects as a group for a better coordination, for a better management. There was an organization, XYZ company. This particular company is working on three projects at the same time. They are making low-cost house project, they are making apartment project, they are making commercial office project, which obviously all the three are similar kind of project. So what they are doing, they are managing all the three together for a better coordination. Suppose they purchased an item. Okay, they purchased some item, some material for the construction. They used it over here into the low-cost house project. And they have planned that they'll be using it on all the, like the basic thing, like kind of bricks and all, very basic, without which construction cannot be done. So they used it over here. Then they saw that the quality of the bricks that they were using is not the same that they want. So obviously, they are not going to use that for the same brick over here also, just to kind of experiment. So it's like, once they used it over here, they know that this is not good, that they are not going to use it over here. So for a better management, we have program. So in many organizations like Google, in very big organizations, even in small organizations also, who are working on two similar kind of projects, they have a complete different department called as program. So in those organizations, the project managers report to the program managers. So for program management also, there is a specific different course that is done. But yeah, in some organizations, there is a department of program, but in many, they aren't. So, but for future reference, if you are moving, if you are going to any organization, or if in your organization, something department like this exists, that is why I'm telling you it over here. Now, the second term that is used, that is quite popular, is called as portfolio. What is portfolio? Portfolio is program. Project, operations, all managed together to achieve strategic objective. The portfolio is the topmost level. Over here, what you are doing, you are managing everything in your organization together just to achieve whatever is the strategic objective of your organization. Let me take an example of Apple. So what products Apple have? Apple have iPhones. Apple have MacBooks. Apple have iPods. Apple, what else Apple have? iPhone, Mac, iPod, earphones. Apple have, Apple have watches. Yeah, Apple have watches. Okay. So these are the products that Apple have. Now in iPhone, there are so many different phones available, like 14, 11, 6, 8, 9. In Mac also, there are different versions, two operating systems, something like one, different. In iPods also, there are different. They keep on upgrading every year. In earphones also, in watches also, so many watches they keep on launching. So these will be considered as a project over here. This is your program. Now, right now, we are talking about the electronics department of Apple. Suppose Apple set up an objective like by 2020. Suppose by the mid of 23, suppose June, by the mid of 23, I want to do a business of $1 billion. They are setting up this target that by June, they want to do this for a business of $1 billion. Doesn't matter. Be it iPhone, be it Mac, be it iPod, be it earphone, be it watches. Well, all of them are different from each other, but still all of them are going to work keeping this objective in mind. They will be working to make sure that they are able to achieve this particular objective. So this is portfolio. Portfolio is the top level of management wherein you are managing everything. From one thing into your mind that you want to achieve whatever your organization's objective is, objective or target is. Clear, guys? Program, portfolio, project?
Inshallah, it's clear.
Oh, okay.